gave you fair warning, beware. I gave you fair warning, beware.
You know, people come under many strange things, but that's not something that I, Queen My Agent, prescribes to. It's just not.
Mm-hmm. You ever heard of a sister by the name of Beautiful C-A-C-H?
Yes, I do. Yes, I have. Hold on, Earl. She is here. She is here.
That's what I gotta get.
Yeah, she's here. Yeah, she's here. Mm-hmm.
I want to add on to that.
When you see her, tell her Sonetta is looking for you.
Let me add on to
Sonetta. Peace to the queen. Peace to the goddess. What's going on?
Peace, family. Got my sister Halima.
Peace, everybody.
I'm trying to think about if I was in her closet.
I don't know.
Or Mind Detect Mind, right?
Now, this wasn't planned.
No.
Y'all both put on the set. This wasn't planned. Mind I take mine.
Peace, everybody. Beautiful C Asia. Live here with the family in Mecca. It's good. And I, like I had said on my Instagram, you know, Ramadan Mubarak to all the beloveds that are in practice. I'm with you. Definitely going through a lifestyle cleanse and fast. Not always dietary. Coming up with me, Jay. I've been peaceful and willingly all of us that are out here doing the leg work are peaceful. We are in a dynamic change and time. I know that for people that are in tune, especially with environment, you can sense and you can actually see the transformation and transition that we're going through as a community. And I want to be able to just briefly point out, and I do often, about the transformation that's going on in the tri-state area here, because this is once the Mecca and the metropolis of the original people of America. We have been very impactful here in New York City and New Jersey in terms of influence, starting with the history of hip hop, starting with the history here with the Gods and Earths, with the Ansar community, with the Pan-African community, with the Nation of Islam, many communities here in the north of America, right? So with this transformation, with quote-unquote gentrification, I speak on this about how a lot of New York and New Jersey, two of the number one states in America right now, that are being cleansed, that are being geographically cleansed, and people are being pushed to the south. People are being pushed to the suburbs. It's very similar to when they knocked down the projects in the inner city and they turned the projects into townhomes or into flatter tenements, right? In New Jersey, in Chicago, in Baltimore, they knocked down all the high rises. So they shifted the community. Well, now we got another layer of a shift, and it's called gentrification. But it's a lot more than that. We have to really do the knowledge to what's happening. We're being pushed back down south. Black people, original, indigenous, aboriginal, whatever you want to call it, to all my Moors out there. And I'm with you. We are being pushed to the south, and we're being pushed off the shores. There's reports of Chinese people buying up New York City. There's reports of Chinese people buying up California. The coastal states are being shifted, and we're being pushed to the middle. And why do I bring this up? because I have to. If New York can be dominated the way that it has economically, because it has, Harlem is now transformed, Brooklyn is now transformed, the Bronx is now, I actually saw an ad for a dog watcher. They had a dog sitter position in Bed-Stuy. A dog sitter position in Bed-Stuy. So that should tell us that once you conquer the mind of Black America, because the tri-state is the mind of Black America, once you conquer that, we have to do the knowledge and make sure that we're prepared, that we're not running west and that we're not running south to repeat our unpreparedness that we were in bigger cities. I need us to be very clear, very mindful of what's happening with weather. And all states, it's not just the tri-state, it's California, it's snow in Florida, right, snow in Texas. Be very mindful of the dynamics of what's happening into America. Why? Because it's written and it's in the Word, not just the Bible. We understand that that's the dichotomy of America. But because our ancestors like Elijah, that most of our culture spin off of, have given that word. And listen, it's not about black and white at this point. It's just about being in your higher realm and being prepared. Being prepared as a community. Us being aware and being mindful about the times that we are in. Never allowing culture at this present moment to allow you to be so comfortable that we forget our preparedness. Never allowing television. Never allowing the lifestyle images on Instagram. Never allowing all of this shit that you see on camera to fool you and lullaby you back into what you knew better. We have done this legwork, brothers like Sonetta, The Pills, Noble Ampu, Khalid Muhammad, we can go on. Shaka Musa Barashank, many elders, John Clark, everybody that's been here, Dr. Ben, have laid the groundwork. Father La have laid the groundwork for us to learn. Do not ignore that for those memes that you see on Facebook, those positive memes that exist, but the lower always will. So being prepared, being mindful, do not run south and find yourself back in an apartment and not acquiring land. Allodial title to land, researching this. Do not get back into the confines of not growing your own food, because when I come south, it's time to grow food. It's time for me to take heed and remember what I was taught and what I learned. That's why I'm still here, because I have to get ready. I cannot come south and ignore what our ancestors have been through. Whether we're talking about young Malcolm, do not forget he's been thrown off of a roof for you to stay in your alertness and your awareness. Do not forget the Bloods and Crips who've been locked up, who was once our vanguard, who's been thrown in a cell at one time in the imagination to thinking that they were going to protect us. It's not in vain. Nothing is to fall in vain. Stand on your 1-2.
Now, let me ask you, a lot of people don't know, but you got boots on the ground. You've been putting boots on the ground for a long time. People might say, well, you know, all they do is talk. But this is one of the sisters that I could tell you who have boots on the ground. Talk about that work that you be doing. The last time I seen you, you was in. All right, you see, she getting love right there. I know you from, brother.
I used to be up 125th Street all the time.
There you go. Right. Yeah, but see, a lot of people may not know, but you be having boots on the ground. You do the field work. You be out there, you know, doing the work for the people. Talk about that and the struggles that we still face.
We're our own worst enemy.
Say that again.
We're our own worst enemy. There is no enemy outside of us. It's boogeyman action. We put so much idea into a force outside of us. That's the Mormons walking through your neighborhood and they got a hold of your grandmother and into Christianity and then they pass down that consciousness to you to think that the Lord is outside of yourself. Pardon self, G. So anyway, yes, work being put into the streets and the community still, but quietly, because we don't do it. With all of, and I want to talk about this real quick too. One of the things that I have an issue with and that I find in doing the work is what we don't talk about is the role and responsibility of women. But guess what? As they put the women up on a pedestal culturally and socially right now. Through media, you see a lot of women empowerment, because that's the Jews doing that. So, of course, black women are gonna follow, okay? So, with that in mind, we have always had a huge importance and significance on the direction and the course of our males and our men and our boys, and been very responsible for the welfare and the condition of even the dissatisfaction that we are in with them now. We have been very responsible for that. We have honored their bullshit and have not given them reason or factor for why they should grow, evolve, and develop. When the brothers see me, they automatically think of ascension. When they see me, it automatically triggers them a reminder that they should be on their 1-2 and their 3. So when you see these sisters, and some of you and many of you are out here doing this shit, you know it's your complaint. It ain't my complaint, because I don't feel that slavery story in my bloodline. That ain't my story.
That's right.
But for you sisters who honor and encode and program the slavery story in your bloodline, and then you got your ass out here hanging out in the name of black magic or black woman power, you got your twat hanging out in photography, you got your nipples hanging out, your nana was just, I just had this bill, your grandmother was just swinging with the muumuu over her head, rape, according to you. This is according to you. My nana been through this. My nana was hung, thrown in the river. My grandfather had to escape and run to Ohio and Indiana because his ass got whooped because he was blamed for raping white women in the South in the 1930s. So how do you find it so soon without any clearance? Not empowerment, in power. Not empowered, in power. How do you find yourself so prematurely, so soon, ass naked across the internet, across magazine spreads, and you yourself have embraced the story of slavery? You yourself have taught this logic to yourself and your children, and you know a part of it has existed. So how do you find yourself already in the rivers, ass naked, soliciting yourself out here in the name of black magic and black beauty? If we got steps to take for healing, if you know men are still getting their ass knocked back, their wig being knocked back, niggas is still filling up prisons, how do you dishonor that struggle right with your ass being right out here ass naked? And there's nothing. So you think Caucasians is gonna look at you in Texas and respect you? You think Caucasians is gonna respect you as you move your ass to Baton Rouge, Louisiana? They're not. Because the last time they checked your ass, you was on Empire, ass naked. The last time they checked you, you was on music videos, ass naked. The last time they checked you hoes, y'all was twerking on Facebook, twerking. And the brothers share this shit. The brothers share this shit. So, with that being said, if you want a so-called enemy outside of you, you do your, if you have your proclivities and you freak booty and that's what you do, I understand. We all got our alter egos. There's a way you do your shit. But for as long as you know that you're not in power and not empowered, you sit your ass and you cover your ass up to a degree and you let motherfuckers guess what you do. You don't know, you don't give away your goods, nigga, and you haven't even earned that. You don't take a college degree as some type of exchange for how the hell your grandmother was swinging from a fucking vine. You can't justify that. That's the story you saying, right? That's what you sharing to your young God and your queens. If you know that's the legacy, then I advise you to clean up, sister, because it's you that's making that mark. And this is the kind of work that I do on the streets.
That's good. Thank you, queen.
In a non-UC filing, the living collapsing and controlling the trust. Our brothers are in these Albion dark magic courts, and your last question kind of segues into what I'm doing now, which is trying to crush the courts and the dark magic with the magis in all these administrative venues. Has any one of you have made an effort to integrate the metaphysics of Phil Valentine with what you're doing, Asar, in crushing him with paperwork, as also coaching and navigating through these systems and controlling our vessel, because we're forced and compelled with a birth certificate theft of the Cessna K Trust and the Mortmain Act, as well as the various collapsing of the federal debt and HR 192. I can go on and on, but is there any type of manifestation or integration of the metaphysics so we can have Noble Drew Ali, his declaration of the 10-10-59 in Cook County, and integrate it in the paperwork so we can get all our brothers and sisters out of these crooked, false magic administrations, though.
What was that? I understand that the UCC was actually put in because that was an alternative to natural law. It was placed there in order to do business. We became commodities. Human beings became commodities. So we had to act as functionaries within that system. Trump just signed a bill that's going to bring us back onto the gold standard.
Right.
Y'all hate him, but that fool is doing what he's supposed to be doing.
Right.
Nobody can deal with $163 trillion debt anymore. So the bankers had to make a deal. They went with the cryptocurrencies, and we're going back on the gold standard because of BRICS. So what I'll say to you is the UCC won, and the UCC non-UCC are going to be obsolete soon. And you're going to go back to natural law. That means the autochthonous indigenous now will rule the land.
Right.
But it's a matter of us now becoming.
Listen.
We have to grow our maturity. We have been stultified. We went through a series of 400 years of arrested development. And during that time, our true status and identity as the indigenous blood people of this land here were taken from us and assigned to this denizen. So, as my distinguished panel guests know, you essentially are going to have to stand on your square and pronounce that, revising, getting rid of all of your entitlements. But even though you use them, maintain your status as a diplomat only walking upon the land. Never do business on the ocean with them. Never. Always come back on the land and make sure that before you even think about going to court, you file that paperwork stating that I don't do business in that court. And if you're forced in that court, force them to remove that banner, that flag that gives them the authority. It is us to learn. But we don't have the schools. We don't control our children's minds. These are the schools that they need to be attending. We are actually establishing a foundation for you to take your children out of school and teach them how to become Hue, H-U-E, man, beings.
I see.